Lord, saints.
Praise the Lord.
Can't hear y'all like y'all.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. My God is an awesome God.
Yes, He is.
He's a way maker.
Lord.
Oh, grace of Heavenly Father, we come unto you with thanksgiving in our heart once again.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord, for allowing us to be in your presence. You stopped by this morning, you woke us up this morning, took us with a finger of love. And our eyes we could see this morning. Woke up, our limb was moving and working, doing just fine. We ain't get no bad phone call. Amen?
Amen.
Alright. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Holy Spirit, have your way. I have a scripture number I want to share with y'all this morning. It comes from 2 Timothy 3 and 16.
Woo!
It says, all scripture is given by inspiration of God.
Praise the Lord.
And proper for doctrine, for reproving, for correction, for instruction in righteousness. But we all know time that will come when they will not endure sound doctrine. The cross of Christ is God's prescription, order for us to live, and a way of living. But I thank be God that giveth us victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. All scripture is given for inspiration of God, which means it is the word of God and proper for doctrine. All who would believe and teach us and do, we must be based and squarely on what the Holy Spirit is telling us. And for reproof, it uses for the word of God and set it direction for which way you should live. The Bible is the only guide for which instruction we need to live for our Lord's sake. And I thank the Lord for the word of God. I thank him for his correction. I thank him for being who he are and what he is. You know, a lot of times, many of us, we want to read a good book to tell us how to be good wise, good husband, how to do this and that. But you know, for some reason, we come short of reading the Word of God. And we just, the Bible is basic instruction before leaving this earth. You know, we have the Word of God to guide us, to lead us, instruction us, to tell us which way to go. And you know, as Christians, you know, we all should come to the fork of the road. You know, if we want to be about our Father's business, we got to do what God says, the Lord says. And you know, we can't do it in our own willpower, with our own strength, with our own might. We need the help of the Lord. And so, you know, proper faith produces proper work. And I thank the Lord for his Son, Jesus Christ, who died on Calvary's cross over 2,000 years ago. You know, it was something dead over there 2,000 years ago, and he made a way for us to enter the kingdom of heaven.
All right, man.
And we got something joyful and we're ready for the shout about, saints. Hallelujah.
Right. Hallelujah.
And Lord, we thank you for your Son. You know, I come to the fork of the road where it's not my power, my will to do anything. I know I need help from the Lord. And I know without him, I can't do anything. And without him, I don't want to do anything. And I need the Lord in my life. We all need the Lord. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
So, as we sit here today, you know, give God your all now. You know, we come into the house of the Lord, we should come with thanksgiving in our heart, we should come with praise, we should come with joy, we should come with love, we should come with, let go, just busting out with tears, just praise and lifting up our Lord. To say, if he be living, he'll draw all men unto you. So we got to praise the Lord in spite of, we got to lift him up. He said, if you draw close to him, he'll draw close to you. Amen?
Amen.
Lord, we want to thank you for the Holy Spirit that you have said, dealt with us, say, you will leave us comfortable. Need somebody to help us, lead and guide us. And we need to come to the fork of the road, church. You know, just do what God says the Lord says. If you want your prayer to be answered, you want to be lifted, he said, cast all your cares upon me, for I care for you no matter what's going on in your life. God's there for you. He's with you at all times. And I thank the Lord for being there. Even though when we try to move him, God's still there. You know, he waits us to turn from our wicked ways and come unto him. Anything that you need is found in the Word of God. You don't have to go searching here and there or running here and there, pulling your tongue or your fingers trying to find out what the answer is to the problem. The problem is found in the Bible. Jesus has made a way. He said, come unto me, all you labor and heavy burden. He said, I will give you rest. What you need rest from? Anything you need rest from, God got it. He got you hooked up already. So you know, you need to stop running. Run to God. When anything you keep going on in your life, don't run from it. Don't be away from him. Run to him. He want to take care of you. He want to see your life. He collect your tears. Every tear that you cry, he collect them face. He's there for us, church. And I thank the Lord for being there for me. I thank the Lord for being there for y'all. I thank the Lord for lifting us up. He said, cast all your cares upon him once again, but he cares for you. No man can do you like Jesus.
That's right.
He's an on-time God. Yes, he is. He may not come when you want him, but he's on time. He'll be there right on time. So hold on to Jesus, unchanging him, and lean not to your own understanding. All the way, acknowledge the Lord, and he shall come back your way. Amen. May God bless you all.
God bless you.
Amen. Amen.
You sure you weren't looking at my notes?